Here's your WNEM TV5 news update.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Frank Turner. Here's a look at the top stories we're following for you today. On the second day of vaccine administration, the United Kingdom's National Health Service advising anyone with a history of serious allergic reactions not to get Pfizer's COVID-19 shot. Two people getting the shot suffering severe allergic reactions. Both have a significant history of allergic reactions and carry the adrenaline auto-injectors. They are recovering. Here in the U.S., the CDC recommends you notify your healthcare provider of your allergy history before receiving any vaccines. In mid-Michigan, Saginaw County battling high positivity rates. The county more than 4% over the state average. As of this morning, the county is at 19.2%. The metric important because it tells officials if they could be missing cases. It's also an indicator of community spread. Cases continue to rise. Saginaw County gaining 130 new cases in the last 24 hours, and 9 more people have died. Michigan State University will not play the Virginia Cavaliers tonight. The Cavaliers announcing someone within the program testing positive for COVID-19. The team did not reveal if the positive test was from a player, coach, or staff member. No word yet on when that game will be rescheduled. And now here's Chris with a look at your forecast.
Frank, looks like we've got 4 days across mid-Michigan later this afternoon, so a little bit warmer than we have been the last couple of days. Overall, though, it looks like we'll be cooling down into the weekend as temperatures crash towards the 30s on Saturday and Sunday. Earlier this week, looked like Saturday could be one of the warmest days, but our system for the weekend is trending colder, and that's bringing temperatures down a little bit, and also the possibility of some snow is there over the weekend as well. First Warn 5 Sky Tracker shows we've got clouds remaining pretty stubborn at the lunch hour today. As we go into the afternoon and evening, some of that cloud cover will clear out, so there are some areas that may get lucky with some late-day sun, but most of the area will probably be stuck under the clouds a good chunk of the afternoon. As we go into tonight, skies will clear even more. Could start with a little patchy fog tomorrow morning, but otherwise Thursday looking like a really nice day, and temperatures should be in the mid-40s tomorrow. The weekend storm system, monitoring trends, still a little too early to talk specifics, but odds are increasing that at least parts of Michigan will see accumulating snow this weekend if trends hold. There are some areas off to the south that may see a bit more rain and a bit more mix, but those off to the north around the Tri-Cities and to the north and west of there could see some significant accumulating snow. We'll see how that plays out as we get closer and see what happens. It looks like we'll get our first real good look at that system by tomorrow. Your 7-day forecast shows mostly sunny skies Thursday, evening showers on Friday, rain and snow both possible depending on where you are Saturday, and then Sunday, some morning snow showers, and then we dry out Monday and Tuesday.
Remember to tune into WNEM TV5 on air and online 24/7 for the latest news, weather, and information.